Good morning, students. Today we will discuss about the flip-flop. So first of all, in our previous lectures we have seen about the number system, logic gates, and how we can design circuits with help of logic gates. So this is basically in previous lectures we have studied the what about the Boolean algebra and how we can use the K mapping for solving the Boolean expressions. So this is basically a K-map or different types of methods we have to opt for optimizing our expressions. Yeah, what type of digital electronics we have given the equations for expressing our digital circuits. So first of all, if we are talking about the half adder, full adder, subtractor, so multiplexer, demultiplexer, so all these circuits are made from a AND gate, OR gate, so different logic gates. So by using the logic gates, we can design a many circuits. So this type of circuits which are used only the present input. So this type of circuit is called as a combinational circuits. So in our previous lecture, we have seen so many combinational circuits. In this type of circuits, present input, what type of inputs we are given, so that input is responsible for the output. But here, when we start our flip-flops, before starting the flip-flop, we have seen about the sequential circuit, because flip-flop is a sequential circuit. So before starting flip-flop, we have seen what about the sequential circuit and what is the combinational circuit. So what type of study we have done in our previous lectures, half adder, full adder is a combinational circuit and output is depend only on the present input status. So this is basically when you have to want to convert your combinational logic into the sequential circuit. So what you have to done? So first of all, you have to require a memory element. Okay. So what about, and basically sequential circuit is consist of a feedback path and it is also requirement of a memory element. So now here we will see that here sequential circuit that is equal to combinational logic plus memory element. So what will the role of our memory element? So here we have to see, if we are talking about the sequential circuit, so there are so many classifications. So first of all, we have to classify our sequential circuit into two parts. First one is called as a synchronous. So what about the synchronous? So if we are talking about the synchronous circuit, so output change only a specific time period. So there is a given specific time period at which your output will be changed. And after passing that particular specific time period, whatever your input, your output will not be changed. So that is basically the synchronous. If you are talking about the asynchronous, so that is asynchronous, output change at the any time. Means there is no specific time. When your inputs are changes, your output will be changed according to that particular input. So this type of sequential circuit is called as a asynchronous sequential circuits. Again, according to multivibrator, we can again classify our sequential circuit. So what type of multivibrators can be used? So first of all, that is a bistable multivibrator, monostable or one-shot multivibrators, and astable multivibrators. So how we can define these multivibrators? So that is basically when we are talking about the bistable, so two stable states are in the bistable multivibrators, and generally we can call it as a two output stage devices. So generally bistable is used as a flip-flops or latches. So now we will start our lecture from starting the flip-flop. So first of all, we will see what about the latches, and we will see then what is the flip-flop and what is the difference between latches and flip-flop. So that is basically the latches and flip-flop is a sequential circuits. And what is the basic requirement of sequential circuit? The basic requirement of sequential circuit is feedback path with a memory element. So now we will start here from sequential circuit. So this is a very basic block diagram, combinational circuit. You have to require a memory element, and these combinational circuit is required a feedback path. So you can see here, so that is, this type of system is called as a asynchronous. And if you have to given the clock signals, if you are talking about the synchronous system, you have to require a specific specific time period. So for a specific time period, you will provide a clock signal. So that type of circuit we will call it as a asynchronous circuit. Now, what about the memory element? So generally we are discussing, you have to give any command, there is a memory element, and what type of input you have to provide, that will be particularly stored in that memory element. So device which can remember value indefinitely or change value on a command, that is called as a memory element. So that is basically a storage. In this type of table, we will discuss about our next topic. So generally, if you are talking about the clock signals, okay. So what type is a clock signals? Because in our previous lecture, we have said that basically there is a particular instant or a specific time. So what is the role of clock signal for providing a particular time or particular instant? So that is called as a positive edge. Sometimes it is called as a negative edge or positive clock pulse or negative clock pulse. Means there is a four types of clock pulses. If you are providing the positive edges, means only when your signal will be rising from where low value to high value. So that particular edge will be called as a positive edge. When your signal will be downfall from high value to low value, so that particular edge we will call it as a negative edges. And this is the complete duration of your clock pulses, and this complete duration is called as a positive clock pulse, and this complete duration is called as a negative clock pulses. So sometimes you have to given the specific edges, so that is called as a positive edges and negative edges. And sometimes you only use the complete duration of your pulses, so it may be either positive half cycles or it may be either negative. So what will happen here? So this is called as a positive pulses and negative pulses. Now we will again, so according to that, as we have to told you, pulse triggered or edge triggered. So positive clock pulses and negative. So that is the classification of pulse triggered. If you are talking about the edge triggered triggering, so that is the positive edge triggering or negative edge triggering. So this is the types of triggering, and these type of triggering we are using in our flip-flop. So now we will see about the flip-flop. So first of all, we will see the latches. So what about the latches? So basically, flip-flop latches is a basically a low version of our flip-flop. So at initial stage, flip-flop will be at the particular latches. So what about the SR latches? So SR is your input signals, and Q and Q bar is the output signals. And you have take the NOR gate for designing a basic flip-flop. So that is SR latches is a very basic flip-flop from where you have to start for your flip-flop. So first of all, before starting the flip-flop, we will see the latches. You can see here what is the basic characteristics of our latches. So here we will see that there is a particular whatever input, suppose your input is 00, okay. So what will be the state if your input is 00? So suppose your state may be either 0 or 1. So there is two possibility, okay. So that is depend on either your Q will be 0 or your Q will be 1. So according to that, if your Q will be 0, so Q bar will be 1. So that is the basic condition. And we can see here, if your both the inputs are 0, your output Q will be 0. If both the inputs are 0 and previous state is 1, so this state is also 1. So what will happen here? It will indicate that when you are applying the 00 at your input terminal, okay, so your output will be not changed. When you are applying 00 both the terminals of your latches, output will not be changed, it will be the same as the previous state. So you can see here Q is equal to Q0, whatever the previous state, that will be the equal. So now what will happen here? Because we are giving the feedback to their input signal, so what type of inputs are there? Same will be connected to their output signals. Now, in again, we have given the 1 to the R terminal. So, R terminal is called as a reset terminal, and S terminal is called as a set terminal. So, if you have given the R as a 1, and now what will happen? If previous state is 0 or previous state is 1. So, that is basically whatever the state of that, your output Q will be zero because you want to reset your flip-flop. Means you have given the zero, okay? So you have given the one to the R. So R is a active signal, okay, for resetting the flip-flop. So if you want to reset your flip-flop, you have to given the R as a one. Now what will happen at the S terminal? When you give the S terminal as a 1, your flip-flop will be set. So this is the condition, whatever the previous value, it doesn't matter, okay? If you have given the R as a 1, it will be reset. Whatever the previous value, if you have given the 1 at the S input, your flip-flop will be set. So this is the basic characteristics of our latches, ki how our latches are work. So latches is basically a memory element, and it is depend on the previous sections. Now here again we will see again the latches. So there are generally this table is very small. When you are giving the 00, your output will be same whatever the previous stage. So that is equal to Q0, no change. When you have given the 01, flip-flop will be reset and your output Q will be zero. When you have to given the 10, means S will given to the 1. So at that condition, your output Q will be 1 and your flip-flop will be set. And when you have to given the 1 and 1, so it will be the invalid conditions. Okay. So this is the basic characteristics of our SR latches. Now what about the controlled latches, and why we called it as a controlled latches? So SR latch with controlled input means there is a controlling of your input sections. So how you can control your input sections? So you can see just here we are adding the two AND gate. SNR inputs are basically the output of a AND gate. And what the inputs you have to provide it? Your input is the R and S and the clock signal C. So this is a slight modifications of your latches. And now what will happen in this particular condition? So you have to see here R and S, okay? So that is the RS input and you have to given the clock signals. And this is the AND gate, means it will work only when both the inputs are high. And it will works only when both the inputs are high. So now what in which conditions it will be high? So when you have to given the reset one and clock signals again at particular signal is high, then your output will be high and it will be given to the NOR gate. So this is the conditions ki when your clock signal is not high. So you can see here, always when your clock signal is high and you have to given the 00, 01, 10 and 11, your output will be the reflected. Otherwise, if clock signal is zero, your output will not be reflected. What type of inputs you have to given the SNR terminal, your output will be no change. Always same as the previous value because it is not working. So for working of SR latches, what will happen? Your clock signal will be active. And this type of controlled, okay? So this type of controlled latches will be called as a flip-flop. So this is a basic working principle of our SR flip-flop. So I think you can understand what is the difference between SR latches and SR flip-flop. If you are working on the SR latches, there is no controlled input, there is no clock signals, your output will be changed at the any time. But when we are working on the SR flip-flop, what will happen there? Your clock signals will be high and you are providing, when your clock signals are high, then we will see what is the input provided by R and S terminal. So according to input of S or R, your flip-flop will be set or will be the reset. So all these phenomena is depend on the clock signals. If your clock signal is low, there is no reflection of your input at the output signal. So this type of controlled SR latches is called as a SR flip-flop. So this is the basic difference between latches and flip-flop. Now you can see here ki there is a problem. Yes, there is a problem in SR flip-flop because we can see here SR NAND gate flip-flop has many advantages and using the sequential circuit. So when we can see there, when set is equal to 0, reset 0, so condition must be always avoided. So what will happen when you are working on the NAND gate, or when we are working on the NOR gate. So what will happen in NOR gate? 1 and 1, it is called as an invalid state, and in this invalid state will be avoided. So now what will happen? So for overcome these problems, so what you have to do? For overcome these two fundamental designs, what type of problems are occurring? The problems are occurring in the SR flip-flop, okay? And for removing these problems, okay, we will develop the JK flip-flop. So what type of problems we are facing? If you are giving to the 1 and 1 both the signals, so that will not be reflected your output terminal. So this is a problem. And for removing this problem, a simple JK flop is used for designs. What will happen? The sequential operation of JK flip flop is same as previous SR. There is no difference. But difference this time is that JK flip flop has no invalid or forbidden input state of SR latches. Means if we have to given the 1 and 1 to SR latches, there will be invalid state. But when you have to given the 1 and 1 SNR input, this time your circuit will not be in forbidden state. Okay. So what is the meaning of this? Meaning of this is JK flip-flop is remove the problem which is occurring in the SR flip-flop. So now you can see here JK flip-flop, basically the gated SR flip-flop with the addition of input clock circuitry, and that prevents the illegal or invalid output condition. So you can see here both the input S and R are equal to logic level 1. So this is a JK flip-flop. You have again giving the feedback connection to the input side. This is the clock signal, J and K. This is the JK flip-flop. The same thing is here, what I have to told you. What will happen in JK flip-flop? Basically, gated SR latches, addition of clock input circuitry, okay? And invalid output condition that occur when both the S and R is 1, it is not happening in the JK flip-flop. Due to this additional clocked input, JK flip-flop has a 4 possible input combination. The same thing is logic 0, logic 1, or no change and toggle. So there are 4 combinations. And symbol for JK flip-flop is similar to that of an SR bistable. So basically, jo SR bistable latch hai, that is equal to the JK flip-flop. And what type of drawback is removed by JK flip-flop? JK flip-flop is again found modifications. If you have done slight modifications, SR flip-flop is improved in order to construct. So you can see here, this is a JK flip-flop. Now what will happen here? JK flip-flop. If both of its inputs are different, the value of J at the next clock edge is taken by the output Y. If both of its input is low, then no change occurs. Okay? When both the inputs is low, no change occurs, and if high at the clock edge, then from one stage to another output will be toggled. Okay, so there is a major role of clock edges. Now JK flip-flop is again set and reset, as we have to see. Now we will see the truth table. You can see here J and K 0 0. So no change, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0. So when your output will be high, and that is depend on the clock signal. So what about clock signals you are giving to your this table? Now we will switch to the D flip-flop. So what about the D flip-flop? Okay, so D flip-flop is widely used flip-flop in digital system. Okay, why we are using the D? Mostly used in D in shift registers, counters, and input synchronization. So this type of flip-flop is most important flip-flop. So what is the role of D flip-flop? D flip-flop is for the most important of the clock flip-flop. So what type of clock flipping flip-flops you are using, in that D flip-flop is very important. Okay, and it ensures that input are never equal to one at the same time. Means what will happen? So first of all, you have to remember what about the D flip flop. So D flip flop is basically SNR. If you are talking about the SNR, so that will be one input is provided to direct and other input is provided after inversion. So if you are providing the 0, it will reflect as a 1. So that is a basic reason behind the D flip flop. D type flip flop are constructed from a gated SR flip flop. So there is no separate construction of B flip flop. It is basically manufactured or generated from the SR flip flop with an inverter is added between the input side. Means if S is if you have to given the S, so R is the inverter of S and you allow for single D flip flop, and this is the basic construction feature of our D flip flop. Then this signal data input labeled D and it is used in place of set signal. So that is nothing else, set, reset. So if you are using the term S and R, so it will be very comfortable to R and S or reset and set terminals. So if this is only thing that this single data input. So what type of heaven? There are not two types of inputs, S and R, like that S and R. Here is only one type of input and that is the D input. So this type of flip-flop is more level sensitive. So you can see here, what is the correction between here? As you have to place an inverter. Okay. So instead of giving S and R different inputs, once you have to given the single input, one input is given to direct and another input is given to the after inversion. So you can see here after inversion, this is a clock signal, both are synchronized, both gates are synchronized at the same time. Okay, then we receive our output Q and Q. You can see here the truth. If you have to given the 0, if you have given the 0, 0, 1, 0. 1, 1, invalid state. So there is a 1, 1, 1. This whatever type of input is there may be the output. Okay. So that is basically our truth table of our D flip flop. So there is a negative triggering and this is the positive triggering. Depend what type of triggering we are using in our flip flops. Now we have to switch to the T flip flop. So now what is the T flip flop? As the name knows, T flip-flop. T defines the term toggle. So his name comes from the toggle in SR flip-flop. So we provide only a single input. So if you are giving only the single input, it is called as a toggle. And this is used and this is given to the input to avoid an intermediate state occurrence. So that is the reason. So now this flip-flop work as a toggle switch. If you are working on this flip-flop, so it will work as a toggle switch. Next output stage is changed with the complement of present state output, and this process is known as toggling. Okay, so basically next output stage, whatever the present state, according to that complement of that, next output stage is changed. This type of the process, it is also called as toggling. So what about the toggling? Means output is not stable, it will change. That is a T flip flop. You have to given the input, Q output, Q bar inverted output, and this is the clock signal. So that is the four requirements of our any type of flip flop: toggle input or triggle input, output, complement of output, and first one is the triggering. Now again, how you can construct the T flip-flops? It is also by making the change in the JK flip-flop. And JK flip-flop has only one input which is constructed by connecting the input of JK flip-flop. So that is the same as you have to see in the D flip-flop, as you have to see in the T flip-flop, it is only one input. But what is the difference between D and T? In D type flip-flop, you have to given the different inputs to your gate, but in T type flip flop you have given the same input to your flip flop. This single input, so this is a single input. In simple word, we can construct the T flip flop by converting a JK flip flop. So that is basically a reason how you can generate the T flip flop. So that is a basic construction part, SRLHS, and you will make from it as a T flip flop. So what is a T? So you have to provide the same input to the gate. And there is a clock signals, and this is a feedback path for overriding the invalid state. What type of state we have to see in our input side. What about the construction features? So as you know, all flip-flop is made by different types of gate. Either it may be AND gate, either it may be NOR gates. Inputs of NAND gate, press output button. So what will happen here? If you are starting from the gate, so that is basically made of NOR gate, NAND gate. So input of NAND gate, AND gate. So that is what will happen. But you have to given the input. So present output state Q and its complement are sent back to the each AND gate. So again, there is a feedback mechanism. Okay. And toggle input is passed to the AND gate as input. So there is again a phenomena. How it will work. So these gates are connected to the, so all these are connected to the CLK signals. And in T flip-flop, what will happen here? So that is basically toggle input is passed to the AND gate. So what about the toggle input? You have given the 1-1. So that is called as a toggle input. And that is connected to the AND gate as a input. And there are also a clock signal. So T flip-flop, a pulse train of narrow triggers are passed as the toggle input. So you can see here, this is a J input, this is a K input, both are shorted and connected to the T. And this is your working, when you have to given the clock signal will be high, T will be high, and again feedback path is also high. The previous state also depend on the previous state. So at that particular, you will receive your output signal. So that is a truth table. When T is 0, Y is 0, T is 1, Y is also 1, Y is also 0, 0, 1, 1, 1. So that is what happens here. When your clock signals exist, there may be some output. Otherwise, output may be 0. But we will see the operations of T flip-flop. So basically, what type of signal information, suppose input toggle input is a set to 0 and present state is also 0, so next state will be 0. Toggle input is set to 1, another one is set to 1, so next will be 1. So there is just possibility of happening the whatever out the T input and whatever according to that there is an output. So T flip-flop is again, as we know, if S and R both are 1, so it will be toggle, okay? T flip-flop requires, how many triggers? So T flip-flop requires 2 triggers to complete a full cycle of output waveform. So it is also, you have to remember, frequency of output produced by the T flip-flop is half of the input. So what type of output frequency is provided in our T-type flip-flop, that will be the half of the input frequency. So it is also work as a frequency divider network. So again, we will see applications of flip-flops. So that's the counter, frequency, shift register. So there are so many applications. Up now, we will again turn to the, we have studied about the JK flip-flop, we have studied about the T flip-flop, and we have studied about the D flip-flop. So there is not so much difference. In T and D, we have to connect it upon both the inputs. So there may be certain problems. If you are working on the JK flip-flop, so JK flip-flop, J is equal to 1, K is equal to 1, and clock signal is also 1. So for a long period of time, the Q output will toggle as long as CLK is high. So which makes the output unstable. So due to this problem is called as a race around. When both the inputs of JK flip-flop are 1, so this type of condition is called as a toggle conditions, and this race around condition is basically a problem. And race around condition is basically in JK flip-flop, and this problem can be avoided by ensuring the clock signal at a logic 1 only for a very short time. So in this time, clock signal's duration will be very small, and this is the basically concept of master slave flip-flop. So we have to learn about the master slave flip-flop. What is a master slave flip-flop? So you can see here there are two JK flip-flop. One JK flip-flop is work as a master and another flip-flop will work as a slave. And you can see here your clock signals will be invert off. So same signal will not provided to both the flip-flop. One signal is supposed to clocking is provided, so another will provide as a negative clocking signal. So these two clocking signals are also different. JK Q Q bar, so that you have to give on the all. This is called as a, and all the devices are connected, and this is called as a basic clock. This both the clocks are connected to each other, but opposite means after inverter you can invert your clock pulses and it will be given to the second master slave flip-flop. So that is basically master and slave. First of all, master flip-flop working, after then slave flip-flop is working. So that is based on the these master slave flip-flop. So clocking is different. One is positive clock triggering and another is to the negative clock triggering by passing through this signal into the inverter. Now what about the master slave flip flop is basically a combination of two JK flip flops. Okay, so initially says we are working on the single JK flip flop, but now if we are working the two JK flip flop and they are connected in series configuration, so this is the reason. Okay, the master slave flip flop is basic made from JK, and out of this one is work as a master, another is work as a slave. So input from the master slave flip flop is, so that is the same thing, output of the master is connected to the input of the slave flip-flop whose output is feedback to the input of the master. In addition to these two flip-flop circuits, so all these, you know, so in addition, these circuits is also included inverter part. So inverter is connected to clock pulse, and it is in such, first master is given to the positive clock case signals and second it will be given to the negative. So that is the basic terminology which we are working, and now we will see the accurate master slave flip flop. So you can see here working of a master slave flip flop. So how it can work, you can see when clock pulse goes one high, slave is isolated because it will work on the negative clock pulse. So J and K inputs may affect the state of system. So according to J and K, it will be work out. So what will happen when the CP goes back to zero, information is passed from the master slave flop to slave. Means that is the same thing is here, what will have to happen in ripple. So what will happen when first flip-flop is activated and its output will be reflected, and that output of master slave flip-flop will be given to the slave flip-flop. So this is the reason. Firstly, the master flip-flop is positive edge triggering and second one is called as a negative edge triggering. So there may be just a basic structure. Now you can see 0, J 0, K is 1, J 1, K 0, 1, 1. So now what will happen? When K is equal to 1, high Q dash output of the master goes to the K input of the slave, and clock forces the slave to reset. When J is 1, K is 0, high Q output of master goes to the J input of the slave. So that is a basically in which part we have to using and what type of. So when J and K is 1, so it is called as a toggle on the positive transition. So that is the basic terms which are using, that is the master flip-flops, that is a JK flip-flop, that is also based on the master slave SR flip flop, and this is the clock signal master slave D flip flop. So while we are classified it, upper section is made from J and K flip flop, so that is called as a master slave JK flip flop. Second part is made of S and R latches, so it is called as a SR flip flop, and third one is made up from the D type of filter, so that is called as a D flip flop. I think now we will see this diagram. That is the master part, this is a slave part, both are working. Since one clock signal is given to the positive and another clock signal is given to the negative, so first of all it will work for one clock period, and when second will start it will work out. Okay, thus we can see the output of your both the sections. this is M1 and M2, and these are given to the input, and these are the clock signal, means we have clock at the same time. So clocking is done. So now we will see some waveforms for understanding. When it is high, so your first flip-flop will be high, master, QM or master. It will be high. Your second will again give, so when your first output is fed to the second, so your second again receive the high signals, but it will only work. So first one is a positive strengthening, and second one is the negative. So when negative strengthening occurred, your second output will be high. So this is the process. By using this, we can understand our things. Now we will move to the clock pulses high. So same thing is what we have told you, when this is a high, so all things. Now what will happen? Output of master becomes low when clock pulse become high again. So again clock pulse will high. So now what will happen? This remains low until the clock becomes high. So when master clock pulse high, so what will happen? Slave clock pulse will be low. Okay. So toggling take place for a clock cycle. So there will be little bit toggle process maybe happens, and for removing. So when clock pulse is high, master is operational, not the slave. Output of the slave remains low till the clock remains high. So that is the basic reason. When clock is low, slave becomes operational and remains high until clock again becomes low. So what we'll understand, when clock is high, master will work. When clock is low, what will happen? Your slave will work. So that is the basic difference. So toggling take place during the whole process, and output is changing once in a cycle. So this will happen, and this makes the master slave flip-flop is synchronous, as it only passes data with the timing of clock signal. So as we have to know in our previous lecture, what about the synchronous flip-flop? So that is basically reason. Synchronous flip-flop is basically that in which output will change at a particular specific time period. So that is a basically master slave flip-flop. So now again we will repeat here. We have seen here the basic 4-5 types of flip-flop. If you are talking about the initial, so that is the SR latches. Okay. So SR latches, normal latches, it will work as a memory element, nothing else. Now we will slightly modify it. We can done the controlling of your input, and now we will convert our SR latches into SR flip-flop. So in SR flip-flop, when both the inputs are zero, no change, whatever the previous input, when both the when R is set to one, so your flip-flop will be reset. When S is set to 1, your flip-flop will be set, and when both 1 and 1 given to the both the input, it is the invalid state. So now what will happen? These invalid state can be removed by using the JK flip-flop. Okay, so what will that? So before starting the JK flip-flop, we will slightly move to the D and T type flip-flop. So now when we are working on the simple SR latches, okay, so when both the inputs are given to the same input, means direct, both the inputs are same, in that particular conditions your flip flop is work as a T type flip flop. And when both the inputs are inverter or invert of the another, so there may be the D type flip flop. Okay, so these are the, in D type flip flop we have given the different signals at a time, but when we are talking about the T type flip flop, we have given the same signal at the same time, and according to that input signals our flip-flops are working. So now again we are summarize our all the things. So this is a D-type flip-flop and this is a T-type flip-flop. Now again we are moving to the JK. So what will happen in JK? We have given some feedback part to the, again to the input side. So why we are done this? Because we are want to removing the toggle situations, invalid state in our SR latches, and we have to again arrange your logic gates, and according to that we have designed a JK flip. Okay, and if you are giving the JK flip-flop 1 and 1, there is no restrictions, it will toggle to that particular input signal. So it is basically used for removing the problem which is faced by the JK flip-flop. But now what will happen here, you are working to the JK flip-flop, now we have to switch to the master slave flip-flop, because in JK flip-flop there is again a race around conditions. and due to removing that rest around conditions, what will happen? We have not provided the same clock pulses. We have just working on the two flip-flops. Means when you want to design a master slave flip-flops, there are two JK flip-flops. And one JK flip-flop is work as a master and another JK flip-flop is work as a slave. And what type of clock signals you have to provide it? You have to given the positive clock signals to the master slave flip-flop and negative signals to the slave flip-flop. So that is the when master is working, slave flip-flop is not working, and output of your master flip-flop is given to the input of your slave flip-flop. And when your clock signal is negative going is, in that particular state your slave flip-flop is working. So this is the coordination between master and slave flip-flop. And in this places, toggling to take place during the whole process, it will be removing by using the master slave flip-flop. So that is the basic reason, you know, how we can convert. So here is a one thing, one clock pulse is given to the master and invert of that clock pulse given to the slave flip-flop. Now what will happen? Resistor is a, so what type of resistors we are using? Yeah, what type of component or element we are using for storing the signals. So if you are talking about the storage purpose signals, what is the basic property of our flip-flops? Flip-flop is a storage element. So you can write here in this way. You can see this object too. Now what about the second? You can see here. Just you can read out T flip-flop. So what is the T flip-flop? There is a two types of flip-flop which we can design by using the SR latches. D-type flip-flop and T-type flip-flops. If you are talking about the T-type flip-flop, same input is provided and we are working on the D-type flip-flop. One input invert of the other input. So you have to remember. What type of input condition not exist in SR latches? That is basically where both the inputs are 1, and that is called as an invalid state. Okay, so you have to remember what we have told you. Rest around condition, in which type of flip-flop it will exist. You have to also know about it. What is the rest around conditions and how you can remove it. When you have to given the JK flip-flop as a 111, that is called as a rest around condition. And because all the flip-flops output are feedback connected with the input, so all thing is depend on the previous signals, what type of signals you have to provide it that particular type. You can again see here, this is the maximum modulo number. So that is how many counters you can make designing the maximum number of, minimum number of flip-flops for designing this. So we can see here the role of flip-flop. So basically you can also see in microprocessor, microcontroller, we are also using the memory elements, memory registers, and for that particular uses our flip-flops are working properly. So there is a very much important role of flip-flop in our digital electronics, and not only in digital electronics, it is also used in many devices or different types of microprocessor, microcontroller devices we are designing, because microcontroller is basically a job specific system for us, and it is a work on that particular system. So that flip-flop is everywhere useful. Either you want to design a shift registers, either you want to design a counter, or you have to require a storage element for your microprocessor and microcontroller. So I think it will be clear to you what about the types of flip-flop. So in our next lecture, we will see the shift registers, how our shift registers are working, and then we will switch to the counters, how we can design a counter by help of a flip-flop. So flip-flop is a very important device in our digital electronics system. So now I think you have to clear about the five types of flip-flop. Now in our next lecture, we will move to the shift register. So basically we have a little bit introduction. Shift register, as the name you know, shifting off means you are using the more than one flip-flops. So how you can store the data and how your data will be moved from one flip-flop to another flip-flop. So whole arrangement is included in our basic part of our flip-flop. So that is the basic things. So now I think it's okay. Thank you. Thank you very much.